Hello guys, I have prepared some simulations of stress test analysis. As promised in our last video, we'll do some testing to see how it behaves and where our critical points. Maybe we need to strengthen some parts and in some parts maybe we can reduce the mass by taking out some metal. So let's go to our stress analysis. I have prepared two simulations. First, we'll try to simulate hitting a curb or something in, let's say, power slide. So this force here will be acting in the lower section of the wheel. I will be using 10,000 newtons, one ton. I would like to see your comments about this. It's very hard to predict the amount of that force. So I was trying to do some calculations with the weight transfer of the car and the corner weight and trying to find something that would make sense when you calculate some, let's say, 2 G's or something when you hit the curb in a power slide. Or in that occasion, I would like to have this assembly fully safe so that nothing would bend. But when we reach a certain point, I would like to see these pins bending instead of any arms or any points on the subframe. So we'll start with let's first remove the rim. It will be easier to see. For the sake of simplicity, this wheel is fully made of aluminum and it's not spinning, and the shock absorber is locked, and because if we go too far with this becomes an endless story. Maybe not for someone who is more experienced, but for me definitely is. You can set it in so many different positions that it will take years to calculate all this possible. So let's remove the rim and we'll start with the stress here. This is adjusted, it's not the actual deformation. So we'll go with the actual deformation. Actual deformation is very, very small and even hard to see. So I will have to adjust here the scale. Okay, now we're starting to see some weak points. That's exactly what we want. We want this pin to be the weakest point areas on the frame. But let's switch to a safety factor. It's more clearly visible now that the pin will be the weakest point. The upper, of course, not, because we hit it in the lower part of the wheel. But we'll definitely want to make some reinforcement there. I know sometimes it's all about the sharp edges and stuff like that. So the software will find a weak point because of a sharp edge. But when it comes to this particular situation, I think we'll introduce some reinforcement here with the sheet metal. And most likely here you can see that was expected, really. So it was already we had this idea already to introduce some sheet metal here and here on all these junctions of the tubing. Okay, so now I can easily see what's happening with the pin. I will just isolate the pin. There we have it. So you can see we have a safety factor of minimum 0.88. that means that this pin will bend definitely, but it's easy. I can manipulate this with playing with this radius here, and I can play with this hole inside and the thickness, so I can even change the material, but we'll see if it will be necessary. If you look at the scale here and the bar, we definitely don't want to see any red or orange. I would prefer to stay above 3 with the safety factor. It's safety factor is related to a yield strength of the material. So yeah, I can do some more isolations of single components, but it takes a lot of time for a computer to do that. So I will switch to our second scenario. I will check the load here. In this scenario, I've hit it with a 5000 newtons on the up and 5000 newtons to the back. So the resultant is 7000 newtons at about 45 degrees here. So it's like hitting some huge bump or something. Then I will remove the wheel. Regarding that simulation, I would really like to see your comments of somebody maybe well experienced in a stress testing. It's really hard to determine what is realistic, what is not. But let's see the results now. This is von Mises stress, so we can see how much load we get on certain points. It's obvious that in that occasion the upper A arm is suffering the most. We can see some green points here on the lower arm, but nothing significant. Let's switch to the safety factor. Okay, so 4 is orange. This is still okay, but it was planned, and definitely now we can see that it's needed. We will have to reinforce this with sheet metal here, especially because of this connection here, the welding here. And okay, this sheet metal part here is not so strong as the tubing is chrome moly, and this construction steel we'll use. So I think we'll also introduce some sheet metal here to cover this and reinforce. Yes, as I said, the lower arm is quite safe. Yes, the pins will survive that impact. Maybe the upper one. Let's see with the probe. We can see safety factor at that point, 1.97. yeah, still safe, not exactly where I would like to see it, but 197 is still way off a point where the pin will bend. But let's isolate the upright. There it is. It's all covered in blue. Some small green spots there, 7.84 minimum. That's way beyond any bending or cracking. So yeah, I would like to see your comments about the testing. I know it's not realistic because the damper is rigid, wheel is all of aluminum, there's no rubber, So all of this would absorb some impact, but we can call this the worst case scenario. So does it make sense to you, or should I do it a different way? And I would like to see your comments on that. Yeah, we'll do some more testing and some more isolation of the components, but it's very time consuming, so it will not fit in this video. Yeah, but stay tuned, because we're about to start the fabrication of these parts. And yeah, leave a comment and see you next video. Thank you. Bye.